eating each other.
Like and subscribe. Happy Monday, everybody. Here it is, dark 30 in the morning, and I decided to go shoot this place way out in the mountains that I haven't been able to get to early in the morning just because I never think about it. But I thought about it today, and then as I was driving up here, I saw some shooting stars and realized we're right in the middle of a meteor shower. So here goes. I'm going to pull into this one little spot where I might be able to get a reflection of the sky in a part of a lake that's usually pretty calm. But if there's any campers down there bushwhack camping in this one little spot, I'll probably leave them alone so they can have some peace. Oops, missed my turn off in the dark and while I was talking. Imagine that. Yeah, I'll do a little Yui here. Yeah, my talking, taking my mind off of my real objective. Kind of like my wife. I hope she isn't rubbing off on me. Dirt roads usually take us to cool places. Here we are again. This one's a little short one, though. Yeah, this one goes up into the Snake River Range. The Snake River Range is the mountain range just south of the Grand Tetons. Really the same range. It's only divided by a highway that crosses a little pass at 8,500 feet. Yeah, I don't know why the geographers made a highway as a demarcation point on a mountain range, but maybe that's why I'm not the geologist, I don't know, or the cartographer, I guess, is the map makers. This is going to be fun. And it gets a little rough in here. Better put in four-wheel drive. Yeah, I hope there aren't any campers down here. I hate walking in on a camp, driving in on a camp, middle of the night. But this Monday, hopefully all the campers cleared out. So good. No campers. There's a little body of water. This is a little inlet from Palisades Reservoir. So anyway, I'm gonna sign off for a minute and go see if I have a photo op here. Well, it's been about an hour since I turned off at that other little place, and I'm still about maybe 20 to 30 minutes away from my destination. But making some progress. still pretty dark, but that's actually a good thing. That means I might see the sun creeping down on the top of the mountain. I'm hoping to be able to find. I thought I was going to get there too late for that, especially with my little detour up to that dried up section of the lake. And well, we'll see what happens. I do believe I overshot it, but not by very far. This is it, right down here, I think. Ah, this is the gloriousness that I was hoping for. One of these days I'll learn how to use this gimbal. anyway, it's just absolutely gorgeous up here. This is the, we're looking at the Salt River Range. Over here, and it's an amazing little spot. And this is the view over the top of my camera. And yeah, it's kind of worth getting up in the middle of dark 30 to be able to get this done. Yes, I do believe that I could do with a few less aspen trees right there. I doubt if they were that tall last time I was here. But you never know. Waiting for the sun to light up the river and the trees here. So time for a little cup of coffee. Now, if this stuff don't wake you up, nothing will. I already been up for maybe 3.5-4 hours, and the sun's just barely starting to come up. Are you sometimes feeling like you're freaking 68 years old when you're really only 69? This is the answer. Yeah, there we go. Cheers.
Well, my effort to get above the aspens, I had to really elevate my tripod. So I've got to use my rear viewfinder to be able to find things with the tilt screen there. Tilt it down so I can see it.
About 10 years of hoping to be able to get that one in the bag, it's finally in the in the bag or the can or ever type of camera terminology you like to call it.
Well, y'all didn't expect me to come here for just one shot, did ya? There's little places of glory all around this valley. And this is just merely one of them that I saw along the way. I never saw this part this time of the morning. And boy, oh boy, that bowl up there is just really, really gorgeous. Well, this here's my shooting outfit, Nikon D850. Really right stuff, BH55 ball head. And a Sackler 72 inch tall tripod. And boy, those are nice to have. Moose Flat Campground. I wonder if there's a moose around here somewhere. Well, there's something down at the river I gotta go look at. The mountains and the dirt roads are full of presents. I took a little side trip up into the Salt River Range and looked what I found. I just dropped off the hill a minute ago and got some really pretty pictures of the creek down below and the mountains above. Hopefully they'll turn out well. Boy, this big old bowl is absolutely gorgeous. Watching baby critters is just such a joy. And those bear cubs, God, the way they jump around and climb and jump and just goof off. It's really quite fun to watch. And very lucky to find. But always be looking to see where Mom is, and I never did see Mom. Toyota RAV4 isn't good for a lot of things, but it's kind of okay at many, many things. It's economical. You can go through puddles of water like this, and it gets decent gas mileage. And with only eight inches of clearance, it gives me a remarkable amount of places to go because of my skid plate.
Well, the light's getting poor and the photography is starting to suck. And we already went through this area when we were on our way up. And we're going to get down here on the main section of the road here in a second and head on out of this beautiful little mountain valley. Now this here is the main road, and there's still some pretty places along the side here. Look at the picture on the upper left and you'll see why. I stopped and took that very, very rapidly because this, even though this is fast forward, there was a bunch of traffic on this road. And so, you know, I don't really like going up here too often, you know, never on weekends. But this time of day, even on during the week, it gets a little busy. Well, sadly, my little mountain up here has got full of people and driving like crazy, and everything's gotten really dusty. That's why it's really valuable to get up here early and get off of this main road. Even though it's kind of out in the middle of nowhere, it's a really popular place, and half of Utah shows up here every summer. And I don't blame them for it. Now here we enter the narrows of the Grace River Canyon. On the left, you can see how pretty it gets in the autumn from that photo. On the right is a picture of one of the local ranchers. And now we're approaching into the town of Alpine, Wyoming, a growing semi-metropolis. It's growing like crazy because after the pandemic, people don't want to ride an elevator anymore, and so it's put a lot of more demand on the ranchers to subdivide. Now that gal we just saw on the road, you know, she grazes her cows in the mountains on the public grazing allotments, and it's important for them to keep them because without the public grazing, the small ranches in our valley bottoms will go out of business. Now the ranchers are the keepers of our green space in the valley, and when they can't put the cows in the mountains, they're going to have to go to the second best use of their land, and that's subdivision. That's not going to be good for the wildlife, and it's not going to be any good for anyone. Yeah, getting ready to wrap it up. I'm almost home, about 7-8 miles away. It's been quite a day out there. It was really pretty. Got some good stuff. After I got what I went for, I always go for more, and that's how I ended up on the tops of those mountains and in all those back countries and on a few roads I shouldn't have been on. But I got out of there, and here I am. It's about going on 1 o'clock, and it was good. Adios.